Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Dennis, and I'm from Holland, as you can hear from my Dutch accent. So, back home, in the small town where I grew up in Holland, I was always the last person chosen during gym class. Because I was different. I acted different and had different interests. So, and I also didn't hang out with the boys' groups. I like boys, or better said now, I like men. And because I didn't really hang out with the other boys, I had felt lonely. And I started to create my own things where I could fit in. When I was 15 years old, I produced a mini version of the musical Cats. I grouped several musicians and dancers together, and we gave a stunning performance. I felt alive because I created my own inclusion. 7 years ago, I moved from Shanghai to Hong Kong, and I fell in love with a great guy. Unfortunately, 4 years ago, we broke up. I was also in between jobs, so it was double hard. I did lots of trail running and hiking, but I was not really interested in hanging out in bars or clubs or social media hookup sites. I felt it was hard to meet new people and make new friends, and I felt lonely, just like I was sitting again in the gym class corner. I realized in Hong Kong, there are several LGBT sport groups, but they're mostly hidden and difficult to get in. So I created a group called Out in Hong Kong to organize sport events. And in August 2014, we organized our own first event at Dragon's Back. On a Sunday morning, 53 people showed up. It was a great experience. Now, Out in Hong Kong is the community in Hong Kong for LGBTs and their friends for sport events. And we have more than 5,500 members on Facebook. Everyone is welcome to participate. It's a great way to get out of your comfort zone and help each other. We have a team of 10 volunteers and we organize every week events. I got involved in organizing more LGBT events in Hong Kong. And 3 years ago, I remembered the Gay Games from 1998 in Amsterdam. This was really an amazing experience. The Gay Games is a diversity festival of sports, arts and culture. It's a 9-day festival, including an opening and a closing ceremony. The mission of the Gay Games is to educate people through sports in a spirit of better understanding. Everyone is welcome to participate, regardless of your sexual orientation, gender, disability, race or level. I realized that the Gay Games have never been held in Asia. And it will be a great opportunity to bring this inclusive festival to the place I live in and love in Hong Kong. Because I feel that this is missing. Then I had a crazy idea. I'm bringing the Gay Games to Hong Kong. So the Gay Games are organized by the Federation of Gay Games. And the organization selects the host city because the Gay Games are held every 4 years since 1982. So I sent an email to the Federation of Gay Games. Hello, I'm Dennis from Hong Kong. How can we bring the Gay Games for the first time to Asia? 2 years ago, I collected several friends together and we signed up to join the bidding process for the Gay Games 11 in 2022. Let me tell you more about the bidding process because it's a hard journey. It's a bit like the Olympic Games. We had to start from scratch. We did not have anything. No team, no sponsors, no bank account. So I grouped an amazing team of people together. And we set up a management team. In the last 2 years, we met every Tuesday night together. The first step was to create a 300 pages bid proposal, which describes all the 36 sports we propose, including Hong Kong local sports like trail running and tower run on the ICC. Yeah? And we had also several meetings with the Hong Kong government and local sports organizations, how we can organize this event together. We reached out to the community and the business community to get their support. We received more than 150 letters from different organizations. Solomon is part of our team. He works for a local sports organization and he wanted to ask his boss for support. So he told his boss that he's gay and about the Gay Games. His boss supported him. And since then, Solomon really changed. He became himself. And When I talked to Solomon that I wanted to mention him in this talk today, he said, no problem, you can use my name, you can use my picture. So I'm very proud at Solomon. In March last year, Hong Kong got shortlisted against Washington, D.C. and Guadalajara in Mexico. So 13 cities lost, but Hong Kong was shortlisted. The next stage was to organize a site visit inspection in June last year. 5 inspectors came to Hong Kong, and we visited all the 40 amazing venues in Hong Kong. We organized a community reception at PMQ. We were expecting 300 people, but 600 people showed up on a Wednesday night. It was so hot. It was so inspiring. That week was very exhausting. We did not sleep much. And with the inspectors, we really became a family. They were so inspired by Hong Kong and by our community. When we said goodbye to them at the airport, we really had to cry. It was so emotional. The next step was in Paris in October last year. 12 members of the team flew there together. And we were a bit like a startup, sitting at 7 o'clock in a coffee shop, working our social media, our edits and presentation. It was really amazing. The final pitch in Paris was a 90-minute questions and answers session where voters could ask questions about our bid. I was sitting next to the mayor of Washington, D.C., together with my teammate Paul. Paul kept telling me, please sit quiet on your chair, because I kept moving around. I was so nervous. The day after, the voters selected their favorite host city. And during a gala dinner, the mayor of Paris announced that Hong Kong had won the bid to bring the gay game for the first time to Asia in 2022. Cafe Pacific had sponsored us to fly to Paris. So when we won the Gay Games, they announced this on their internal website. And we received several emails from cafe staff that they were so emotional by this, because this really gave them a greater sense of belonging. They also arranged a special cockpit crew to fly us from Paris to Hong Kong with local lesbian pilot and gay pilots. When we arrived in the airport, in the airplane, flying back from Paris to Hong Kong, the captain announced that he was so proud to have the winning Gay Games team on board, bringing the Gay Games with them to Hong Kong. This was really an amazing moment. Now we have won the Gay Games. We have 4 years left to organize an amazing event in November 2022. And we'll work together with the local community, with the local government, to organize a successful event in November 2022, expecting 15,000 participants and more than 40,000 spectators. The Gay Games in Asia is very important to me, because lots of people who feel excluded normally from other groups or events now have the opportunity and be empowered to be involved in an event that's bigger than themselves. And there is still lots of work to be done to improve inclusiveness in Asia. Every time I get goosebumps and they talk about the Japanese athlete who participated in the Gay Games in 2014 in the United States. He could not bring his medals home to show to his friends or family, because he told them that he's on a business trip, because he could not tell them that he's gay. He could not be himself. Imagine that you come back from your journey and you're not able to share your story to the people you love. How would you feel? The Gay Games for the team has been an amazing experience. We are all volunteers, and some of us have been spending more than 20 hours per week in this project. We are really like a family. We have emotions, fights, hookups, big hugs, and of course, lots and lots of passion. I now have a day job and a gay job. And I'm happy that the groups I created will help the community in Asia to make a difference. So, if you feel that you don't fit into something, Don't be like the 15-year-old boy sitting in a gym class corner. But go out and create your own group and family so you can be included. Thank you.